I'm Dr. Peter. I'm a regenerative physician working at SureCell, and today I'm talking about male hormones. We're going to explain why so many people are getting low testosterone and what we can do about it. First of all, it's somewhat reassuring to know that you are not alone. We're seeing a lot of people with low testosterone in our community today. It's been getting worse over a period of 50 years, and that deterioration has accelerated over the last 3 years associated with COVID. A lot of people are expressing tiredness, lethargy, poor mood, depression. And one of the factors in that is low testosterone. There are other factors as well. Many people really are enthusiastic that they'll fix all their problems just by boosting their testosterone level. But testosterone is in fact only one of many variables that control our energy and mood. And so I suppose the first stage of any treatment is proper assessment. So we need a thorough blood test to measure not only your testosterone levels, but also all the other factors in the blood, such as vitamin D and iron levels, thyroid, that combine to give us well-being. Now, it's a strange thing. A lot of people are coming to see me because they're having trouble accessing testosterone testing. And that shouldn't be the case, because any GP can, in fact, order a testosterone panel. It isn't hard to do. And I don't see any harm in everyone having the facts about their well-being and levels. Now, testosterone regulation is actually very simple, and I want to explain it to you so you'll understand how it is that we'll intervene. So testosterone is modified and controlled through a negative feedback loop. A negative feedback loop is like an air conditioning unit. And what it does is it regulates so you don't have too much or too little. And the temperature measurer for testosterone in the body is the hypothalamus, which sits at the front of the brain. And that's important because it's this frontal area of the brain that's often damaged when people get COVID. So we're seeing combinations of dysfunction in hormone regulation and dysfunctions in sense of smell, people losing their sense of smell, and short-term memory. And these things often go together post-COVID. This dysregulation of the hypothalamus affects the pituitary gland, which secretes FSH and LH, which are the hormones that control the production of testosterone in your testicles. Now, what we're seeing is that after COVID, after poor lifestyle choices, including excess alcohol, weight gain, bad sleep, we're seeing some athletes, particularly some of our boxers and kickboxers, overtraining. And we're also seeing a polluted environment where there's too many plastics, too much processed food. And all of this is contributing towards low testosterone levels. We're also seeing, after COVID, some people are producing abnormal brain hormones, such as prolactin. And the prolactin is actually causing the same sort of loss of libido, loss of energy, that we're seeing in low testosterone. So I believe that in the modern world, anyone presenting with tiredness should also have their prolactin levels measured. Now, my philosophy is always, as we intervene, we should do the minimum amount of damage. And our long-term goal, particularly in young people, is to reset their testosterone production rather than to go straight to TRT, which stands for testosterone replacement therapy. But I tell my patients it also stands for testicle replacement therapy. And what a lot of people don't get is that when they start taking a long-acting testosterone, it's going to actually make your balls go small, and that is going to give you long-term problems. We effectively become hooked on testosterone replacement therapy long term. And I believe any evaluation of testosterone treatment has to include an evaluation of warnings about fertility and whether or not someone wants to have kids later on. Now, the first point in which we intervene in this process is with a thing called Tomcat Alley, which is available in a product called TestoJack, which we supply a 300 milligram dose. Usually people take about 2 a.m. It's very natural. It's a herb. It's quite harmless. It's not as effective as a lot of other treatments, but it can be combined with other things so that we can get good balance in the hormones. Now, the other thing that we're using is HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin. Now, that works in a very similar way to the way FSH and LH work to stimulate the balls to make more testosterone. And we're finding this particularly good for people who've actually got to the point of developing small testicles. It's important to note that when you take a lot of exogenous testosterone and bodybuilder testosterone, etc., the pituitary gets shut down and the pituitary stops making FSH and LH. And Tomcat Alley is one of the few things that we can supply that will get the pituitary going again. So we're trying to restart the pituitary and we're also trying to restart the testicles. And we know that post-COVID, the Sertoli cells in the balls are being damaged and this is affecting well-being and fertility. Now, when it comes to the more difficult cases, some people can't be kick-started with Tomcat Alley and HCG. In that case, they may need a testosterone supplement as well. And I think it's important to understand that there are long-acting and short-acting testosterones. And a lot of people see the benefit of long-acting testosterone because it's convenient. But also, it does lead to long-term shutdown of the pituitary gland, which we want to avoid. So we'll often use a short-acting testosterone lozenger. Now, this will boost your testosterone levels really high for about 3 or 4 hours. And you can take a quarter or 2 quarters or 3 quarters a day, spacing it out, to give you increased testosterone when you need it, when you're working, filming a video, under pressure, or you can use it before sex or training. But it doesn't last a long time, so your balls will still kick in overnight and you'll be making testosterone, your pituitary will have a chance to recover. So my first line is Tomcat Alley, and my second line is HCG, and third of all, I'll use a testosterone lozenger. Now, there are some people for whom the testosterone lozenger isn't adequate, or there are people who have already reached the point where they've got enough kids. They may go to a long-acting testosterone, and in those situations, the choices are injections or creams. Thank you.